Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Imagine you are at a large party with a lot of large circular tables that each sit 10 to 12 people. When you arrive, you have an assigned table, so you go put your stuff down and then go mingle with the other guests at the party. Throughout the event, many of the guests, including yourself, will walk around, stopping at various tables to talk with people and just continuously move around the room. The number of people at the party doesn't change. The location of the tables doesn't change. But there is a sea of people wandering around the space at all times. The guests at the party are behaving how the electrons in a metal behave. And the tables are the positively charged nuclei of the metal atoms. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to describe how metals form metallic bonds. Discuss how metallic bonds lead to unique properties of metals. Previously in this unit, we learned that when metals form bonds with nonmetals, they transfer electrons and form ionic bonds. We also learned that nonmetals share electrons with other nonmetals to form covalent bonds, which are made of pairs of shared electrons. The last type of bonding we are going to explore in this unit is metallic bonding, or how atoms of metals form bonds with other metals. If you remember back to our second unit on the periodic table, transition metals were the elements located in the middle of the periodic table. When we learned how to use the periodic table to determine the number of valence electrons an element has, we actually skipped these metals. Transition metals usually have one or two valence electrons, but it is impossible to know the exact number based on only the periodic table. Because of this, we didn't focus on them when learning about ionic compounds. However, when forming metallic bonds, the number of actual valence electrons an atom has does not matter. In metals, the valence shells of the different atoms overlap, and the electrons are free to move around all of the different nuclei at high speeds. The electrons are said to form a sea of delocalized electrons. This means that while the valence electrons originally came from a particular element, like you had an assigned table at the party in the opening, when they form metallic bonds, they are constantly moving through the substance and are no longer attached to a particular nucleus, like when you were mingling at all of the different tables at the party. A metallic bond is the attraction between the negatively charged electrons in the sea of electrons and the positively charged nuclei of the metals in the substance. What does this mean for the overall charge of metals? Let's pretend you have 6 atoms of sodium metal. From its atomic number 11, we know that each neutral atom has 11 positively charged protons in the nucleus and 11 negatively charged electrons in the electron shells surrounding the nucleus. When forming metallic bonds, the 6 nuclei stay in one place, surrounded by the electrons in their inner electron energy levels. Sodium has 1 valence electron, and that single electron in the valence shell starts moving around, and together with the valence electrons from the other 6 atoms, forms the sea of electrons. No electrons were gained or lost in the substance, which means the metal, as a whole substance, is neutral. When metal atoms come together and form metallic bonds, they are arranged in a lattice structure. This structure provides metals with their strength and durability. Metallic bonds and the lattice structure formed by the metal atoms are the causes of many of the properties that we associate with metals. If you are baking cookies and reach into the oven to remove the baking sheet when the timer goes off, but forget oven mitts, you will burn your hands, right? Do you know why? It is because metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. The delocalized electrons are able to carry heat and electric current quickly through the metal. Jewelry and wires are often made of metals. This is due to their malleability and ductility. Malleability is the ability to be hammered into shapes, and ductility is the ability to be made into wires. These shape changes are due to the ability of the positive nuclei easily sliding past one another, allowing the metal to deform but not break or crack. Finally, metals are often described as being shiny or having luster. This property is due to the ability of the sea of electrons to absorb and release light, which then appears as shine on the surface of the metal. Often, when people think of metals, they think of pure substances like aluminum, copper, gold, and silver. But metals can also form mixtures or alloys. An alloy is a mixture of two or more metals held together by metallic bonds, same as a pure metal. However, oftentimes these alloys have stronger properties than pure metals. Examples of alloys include bronze, which is made of copper and tin, and brass, which is made of copper and zinc. As we went through the lesson today, we learned how metals come together to form metallic bonds, and how these bonds are directly related to the unique properties of metals. Our next lesson is a review and assessment of what you have learned during our bonding unit. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring.